On behalf of the chapter and the congregation here at St. Paul's Cathedral in Fond du Lac, I would like to cordially invite, welcome all of you to this concert this afternoon. I would like to invite you either during the intermission, there will be a 10-minute intermission, or following the performance itself, to look on the table at the back near the baptismal font and look at the biography of Diane Bish. They're available for purchase. There are tapes and there are CDs back there that are available for purchase. And if you happen to be a keyboard musician yourself, there are some of Diane Bish's own arrangements. Some of her music is at the back as well. They will be all available for purchase during the intermission and following the concert this afternoon. As you may or may not be aware from Diane Bish's tours and TV programs on television, her Joy of Music series, she is a very spiritual person, and therefore we would like to begin the concert this afternoon with a prayer which is found in our Episcopal prayer book for church artists and musicians. Let us pray. O God, whom saints and angels delight to worship in heaven, be present with your servants who seek through art and music to perfect the praises offered by your people on earth, and grant to them even now glimpses of your beauty, and make them worthy at length to behold it unveiled forevermore, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, Diane Bish.
I would like to welcome you to the concert this afternoon to share with you in the great music of the organ. It was Mozart that called the organ the king of instruments. Many reasons it is the king, but several is that it is the grandest of instruments, it takes the most space, and it is the most varied of instruments because it contains most of the orchestral sounds and many sounds of its own. We have heard some of the grand sounds of the organ, and now thank we all our God of Johann Sebastian Bach. Now we hear some of the tiny sounds. Back in the days of Mozart and Beethoven and Haydn, there were tiny little clocks which contained wooden pipes, just like a pipe organ. And these little clocks would play melodies written for them by these great composers. Mozart was once asked, why do you write for these silly little clocks, as Mozart called them? And he said, money. He needed the money. So today we still have these lovely little clocks to listen to. They use the tiny wooden flute pipes of the organ.
Thank you.
About 300 years ago, there was a very famous organist who lived in France whose name was Louis Marchand. And the great Marchand would make tours of the continent. And on one of his tours, he went to Dresden, Germany. And there he was challenged to a competition with a young German organist, which he accepted because he felt that no one could outplay him. So the day the competition was to take place, the great Marchand went to the door of the church to hear the young German practicing. And what he heard so astonished him that the hour the competition was to take place, the great Marchand was seen fleeing into the woods in his carriage, lest his reputation be destroyed. The young German organist was Johann Sebastian Bach, who became the greatest composer for the organ. And I would like to play a famous organ composition of Bach this afternoon, and here's what happens in this piece. First of all, he puts the melody in the right hand, then in the left hand. Then he takes the hands away and the feet play the melody all by themselves. Then he does this again. The left hand plays the melody, then the right hand, then the feet. Then he adds another melody, and he has two melodies, two hands, and two feet. And if you think Bach is boring, it's because you don't have to play it. We go now from the German school of writing for the organ to the French school, the French Romantic, where the composers and the organists played and wrote in a more expressive and more orchestral manner. And we hear a happy little piece, which begins on the oboe stop of the organ, then goes to the flutes, then builds to almost full organ, and then back down to the very tiniest flute. It's called Ronde Française. The last 13 years, it has been my joy to be able to make over 300 Joy of Music programs. And I'm just curious, how many of you have seen The Joy of Music? May I see your hands? Wonderful. Well, if you haven't, The Joy of Music is a television program that in this area, I believe it's on every Saturday night at 9 o'clock on Channel 37. And in your area, it may be on a different time, but it is, I call it musical journeys, and we go to famous cathedrals and play organs on historic organs and show you the scenery. If you don't like the organ music, you can watch the scenery. If you don't like the scenery, you can listen to the organ music. If you don't like either one, you can turn it off and watch Murder, She Wrote. But we've had a lot of fun going around to different cathedrals and making these programs, and I hope it's an inspiration to you. And this next piece was written for the great Notre Dame Cathedral, where we've had some very interesting experiences. The reverberation time in most of these cathedrals and Notre Dame is 9 seconds, so the sound stays around in the room for that length of time. And they don't allow you to practice in the daytime because it disturbs the tourists. So you practice late at night if you're going to do a taping or a concert. The first time I gave a concert in Notre Dame Cathedral, I was practicing late on a Saturday night, all locked in the church. It's very dark and awesome, spooky. And the very loudest pedal note on the organ stuck for an hour and a half. That's called the Bombard 32. Now, that's very low and rumbly. I understand there were hundreds of people lined up outside around the cathedral around midnight wondering what in the world was happening to this great church that had stood for hundreds of years and some dumb American blonde had come to destroy it. And the second time I played there 2 years later, this is the truth, the console of the organ caught on fire and they've never asked me back. Well, anyway, I'd like to play for you this afternoon the Carillon of Westminster, which I have had the joy of recording. And by the way, the recordings are available at intermission and after the concert today of all kinds of music. But this piece begins with the melody in the hands, and then it begins to grow, and the organ, we keep adding sounds to the organ. Then the pedal plays the melody. And finally, we come to full organ, and the pedal plays the melody in an even faster and quicker tempo. So this is a favorite piece of many people called the Carillon of Westminster.
If you didn't get an opportunity during the intermission to purchase some of the tapes or CDs that are at the back of the church, or Diane Bish's biography, or some of her music, there will be an opportunity to do that following the concert this afternoon. The tapes and the CDs include classical music. There are tapes of favorite hymns, many of Diane Bish's own arrangements, and also there are tapes and CDs of Christmas music, which you might want to think about as giving as gifts. They're all available at the back, will be available after the concert. Also, if you would like to sign up for receiving the Joy of Music newsletter, you are welcome to do that, and you can do that at the back table as well. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Mike Russell and Ruth Sperry of the Cathedral, who were responsible for coordinating the concert, and for Jay Capelli and CD Video Productions for making available the video that you are able to see out here, that I'm sorry you're not able to see up here, but you have a much better view of Ms. Bish. As most of you know, Diane Bish does the Joy of Music series. She has been, for a long time, the organist at Coral Ridge Presbyterian Church in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, is now just simply the artist in residence there because of her tour schedule and the number of concerts she plays. She cannot be there every week. And if you would be interested in scheduling a concert of hers, there is information on the back of the bulletin for you to contact Diane Bish Concerts in Bloomington, Indiana. It is really a joy to have such a artist of such style and elegance with us. And again, ladies and gentlemen, Diane Bish.
The organ is made up of families of sound, the flutes, the strings, the reeds, and the foundations, which is pure organ sound. But I would like to now feature the reeds or the trumpets of the organ. There are three or four wonderful trumpets on this organ, and the special trumpet is the horizontal, or we call it enchamade trumpet, which is in the back, which is a horizontal trumpet and is used for solo above the full organ. And I'd like to feature these trumpets in a piece called Trumpet Tune. when we travel around the world making joy music programs, it's not only a joy, but it's also a bit of a burden. We like to make it look like on television like everything is going well and smoothly and perfectly, but it's not. And I say that because the next number I have had the joy of recording in the Freiburg Cathedral of Freiburg, Germany. And in this great cathedral, there are four organs on the walls, one on each wall, and they're all separate, so you can play them separately by walking way up in the attics of the church and finally reaching the organ, but you can also play them from one console, all four of them. And it was quite an experience to record these organs, to set up the, even to set up the microphones so it would work and the sound would all come together in the church at one time. We have had quite some experiences, really, in recording joy music programs in the Strasbourg Cathedral in Strasbourg, France, just to get to the organ, which is 90 feet high on the wall. We have to go up 130 steps, then out on the catwalks of the cathedral. And finally, you reach a creaky old green door where you go into the organ loft, which again is hanging high up on the wall. And after you've done that, then you realize that the ladies' washrooms are downstairs. And then after you've done that four or five times a day, you're too tired to play. So, and then another experience we had was at the Etal Monastery in Germany, where we booked the church in a very cold January. And we didn't realize, of course, it would be one of the coldest days in history. But there's no heat in these churches, so we recorded anyway. And I had to wear a fur coat, and my cameramen wore ski hats and ski suits inside the church. And I warmed my hands between numbers with a hair dryer. Well, we didn't show any of this, but this is what we have to do to make these programs and recordings. But it's all a great experience to play this wonderful music and to hear these historic organs. Now, this number from Symphony Number 6, the Allegro, is a number by a French composer and organist, Vidor. And it begins with great majestic chords. Then it continues until there's a quiet section in the middle where the organist is called upon to play two notes in every measure, two notes in the right hand against six notes in the left hand and four notes in the pedal. It's like patting your head and rubbing your stomach at the same time. And I'm glad that you have a screen where you can really see what's going on. And then, of course, here you can see everything as well. So this is the Vidor Symphony Number 6. I've been a church organist for over 20 years at the Coral Ridge Presbyterian Church in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And the first Sunday I played at Coral Ridge, I went outside after the services, and you know these signboards they have in front of churches? It read, the services 9, 15, and 11. The sermon, What is Hell Like? Come hear our new church organist. Well, I stayed at the church anyway. And one of the things that I love to do is to write arrangements of hymns because they really help me express my faith. And I'm sure there's not one of you here this afternoon that doesn't have a favorite hymn that the words have brought you joy and encouragement when you needed it. And I'd like to play two of my favorite hymns this afternoon for you. The first is a gospel hymn called Come Thou Fount. And this talks to us about God's blessings to all of us every day. And then the next hymn is a very stately hymn of faith called Jesus Shall Reign Where'er the Sun. And the melody starts in the pedal, played by the pedal. It starts very quietly. And then the organ builds until the very end where we have full organ in use. I would like now to play a transcription of an orchestra piece in which we find this beautiful Nimrod by Edward Elgar. And in this piece, Elgar was describing someone that he had very much loved and admired in his lifetime. And we can actually hear this in the music, in the beauty of the music. It begins on the quiet string stops of the organ, builds to full organ, and then back down to the very softest sound on the instrument. It has been a great joy for me to be with you this afternoon and to share with you in the wonderful music of the organ and to be in this beautiful church. I really think this is one of the most unique churches I have seen, even here in the United States, with the beautiful carvings and the woodwork that is in this church. And it's been my pleasure to be here last night as well as this afternoon. I would like to end the concert this afternoon by playing a very well-known piece for the organ. It is loved, I think, because it is quite an exciting piece, and it is built on a theme which is played by the pedals. And in the French Romantic toccata, it is a very usual toccata because the hands take a very fast repeated pattern all the way through the piece, very fast 16th notes, and then the pedal plays the melody. This is the toccata from Vidor's Symphony No. 5.